those examples must be understood. This is the example where if statement was not a very big point, the main problem was when to declare a variable as an int, when to declare as a float. All this understanding you should have when you want to solve big or write application for, some development you do, big programs and you write, all these things would be very much required. So this brainstorming exercise also we did. Then I have, that's all this we start. If else also, this small project I asked finally to do, these are the nested if else statements we discussed. This password login problem also, those logical operators you will know. Now next question is, same using if else statements, write a program to display the grade of a student. You all know the grades, as I told here, if it is greater than 59, 60 and above is the first class, second class 49 above, 39 and above is basically 40 plus is basically third class, and below 40, 39 or any lower mark is declared to be failed. And you have five subjects, physics, chemistry, mathematics, engineering and bio. In every subject, you can score an integer mark. In every subject, you can score an integer mark, physics 40, 60 like this. And we'll take the average and display the grades. I mean, question is, if every subject marks is integer and we find out the average, will the average always be integer or it can also be a floating point number?
It can also be a floating point number.
Suppose it turns out to be 59.6. Suppose the average mark came out to be 59.6. If it is 62, absolutely there is no problem. If it is 38, absolutely no problem. And if I say it is 45, no problem. But if the average marks comes out to be 59.6, in that case, will you declare it as a first class or second class? Which one you want?
First class.
Very good. We will normally be in this case, we can declare first class. If we do that, will our integer division works to declare it's a first class in this case?
No, sir.
Even if I go for a floating point division, even if I write a floating point division, physics plus chemistry plus mathematics plus English plus bio, divided by 5.0. If, let me say, the physics, chemistry, maths, English, bio, I can have two types of expressions. And let me say the marks are, in case of physics, chemistry, mathematics, all marks, let me say P plus chemistry plus bio plus English plus mathematics. And then I write 5 divided by 5, all are integers. And another situation I can tell you, it could be same physics plus all these 5 marks and divided by 5.0. In this case, suppose this sum came out to be, let's say 200.1 or let's say the 200.1 or 201. Will I get a round number in this case, the return value? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
But in this case, will you get a round number or will you get a floating point number?
Floating point number.
Let's say 49.6. You got it. And when you compare it, you'll compare it with whether it's greater than equal to 50 or not. To declare it is a second class. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So it will turn out to be false. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
If you compare this to 50, so you should convert this to a value equivalent higher integer value 50. Agreed or not?
Yes, sir.
Now the question remains.
Sir, can you explain it again?
So when you go on adding all this, turns out to be integer divided by 5.0, came out to be 49.6. Understood or not?
Yes, sir. Understood.
You kept it in a variable. Let the variable be, let's say, X, which is a floating point number. Doesn't matter. And when I compare F with 50.0, will it be true or false? ये ट्रू होगा या फॉल्स होगा?
ट्रू सर, फॉल्स.
लुक एट दिस, एफ इज 49.6.
ट्रू सर, ट्रू, ट्रू सर, ट्रू सर,
ट्रू होगा. 49.6 इज ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू 50.0, इज इट ट्रू?
नो सर,
नो सर, नो सर, 49.6,
49.6,
नो सर,
इट इज फॉल्स. If it is false, will it declare it as a second class or will it declare it as a third class?
Second class.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But our objective is to declare it as a second class. So my question is, converting 49.6 to 49 is very easy. 49.6 to 49, I can assign an integer variable y. Automatically, y will be initialized to 49.6 or 49 if y is an integer variable.
49.
That is very easy. A floating point number can be assigned to an integer equivalent which takes the lower integer value, the floor of that value. Very simple. But the question remains, how could I convert it to the next upper integer number, that is the ceiling of the numbers? Let me tell what is a ceiling and what is a floor of a numbers. If we have a number, let me say a number, let's say 4.6, then we declare a ceiling and we also declare a floor over here. And the floor appears to be, floor value is 4 and the ceiling value is 5. 4.6. The ceiling is 5, the floor is 4. Is it understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
My question here is, how do I get the floor value? If floor value ke samajh gaya, sir, it's very simple. Let's assign it to a variable and which appears to be integer variables. I'll immediately get the floor value or not?
Yes, sir. Easily.
Yes, sir.
But my objective is 4.6 must be initialized to the integer variable A at 5. Do you understand my question?
Yes, sir.
4.5 will become equivalent to
5.
And that will be assigned to the variable. I want to do this. How could I do this? It's not 4.5. Let me clarify. It's not 4.6. It will be 4.1. 5.1 should be initialized to 5 or 6.
Five.
In the ceiling.
Ceiling. Ceiling. No,
yes.
Sir.
If it is 5.1, it should be initialized to
9.4.
In ceiling, it should
be initialized to 10. How could I do this?
The math function
is by adding one.
Anyone?
So math function, using that function.
So let's go int mein convert kar denge fir plus 1 kar
denge. Sir, using the function.
In that case, 5.0 is 5 or 6.
Sir, using
the round function.
5.
Very simple. Let me say, whatever number you have, add it with 0.9 and then assign it to an integer variable A. Is it understood? Tell me yes or no.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Excuse me, sir. Yes,
yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. Sir, can you please explain once again?
Did you attend the class since the beginning or you just now came?
No, sir. I was there since the beginning.
The question is, do you understand what is a floor and ceiling?
Yes, sir.
Floor and ceiling. Given a floating point number, I would like to initialize is to the ceiling value to an integer variable. How could I do this? Floor value is very simple. Floor value, I can simply initialize to an integer variable. Agreed or not?
Yes, sir.
But how do I initialize to a ceiling value? How can I do it? I already told the answer. Answer is very simple. Number plus
0.9.
And then you initialize to integer variable. In case of 5.1, you will get 6. In case of 9.4, you will get 10. In case of 5, it will be initialized to 6 or 9, 5.
It will be 6, sir.
5.
How?
5 plus 0.9.
Is it now understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. So then why we declare, sir, A as an int value?
Huh?
Sir, why we declare A as an int value?
Why because not integer? Why not integer, you tell me? If I ask you, why not integer?
Sir, then if we take a number, sir, 4.5 and sir, 0.9, sir, it declare 5.
What I do not get it. Do you understand my question?
Yes, sir.
What is the question?
सर क्वेश्चन ये था कि फ्लोर वैल्यू जो है सीलिंग वैल्यू जो है अगर हम उसको 0.9 अगर ऐड करते हैं तो हमें सर
दिस इज द क्वेश्चन व्हाट इज द क्वेश्चन आई सॉल्व इट इन दैट वे व्हाट वाज द क्वेश्चन
सर हमें
हाउ डू आई सॉल्व इट व्हाट
सीलिंग वैल्यू चाहिए सीलिंग वैल्यू चाहिए
कैसे कैसे करोगे आप बोलो कैसे सीलिंग वैल्यू एंड द सीलिंग वैल्यू इज अ इंटीजर वैल्यू और फ्लोटिंग पॉइंट वैल्यू फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल क्वेश्चन इज
सर फ्लोटिंग पॉइंट
नो
सॉरी सर इंटीजर सर
यू सी 4.6 व्हाट इज द सीलिंग वैल्यू हियर 4.6 व्हाट इज द सीलिंग वैल्यू
4.6 5
इज इट 5 इज इट 5.0 और 5
इंटीजर सर 5
अब तो फिर
5
हां तो इंटीजर
अच्छा
इंटीजर
समझ गया सर
क्वेश्चन या कंप्यूटर साइंस में लेट मी टेल ऑनेस्टली सेम वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड द क्वेश्चन प्रॉपर्ली Once I understand the question, solutions are very simple. Very simple. Now, if you have understood this, now come back to this. So these are very small points, but when we calculate, we may get wrong value because of this. And we must take care of this. We all must take care of this. So if the result comes out to be 62.3, doesn't matter. 72.5 doesn't matter. But when it comes out to be 59.3, some error occurs. And we must take care of those errors also. Now look at this. So program is not very difficult. The gist of this was how do I get the ceiling value of this? Look at this. P, C, M, E, B, P, R, E. You must understand what for the variables I have taken. Name of the variables.
Yes, sir.
Physics mark, C stands for chemistry mark. Enter 5 subjects marks. Now look at this, the divisions. What I did. P plus C plus all this 4.9 I added 4.9 and divided by 5. Yes. The division will be floating. It gives the ceiling value. Will be assigned to the power over here. So, or you divide by 5, then go for, if you divide by 5 and that becomes, let me say, divide by 5.0. You could have done one thing. You
could have divided this by 5.0,
let me say, sorry.
So, why 4.9?
I'm coming. If you do not understand this, I know you what you want to understand. Divide by 5.0, add it with 0.9. Is it understood?
Yes, sir.
You do this. Okay. Once you do this, you can understand why it is 4.9. Okay. Once you understand this, it can be. You do this. What I know what you will understand. You go by that. The rest part is very simple. If a person is greater than or equal to 60, first division, then second division, then else greater than or equal to 40, third division, else there. We can have another way of doing this. Yes.
Sir, why are we using ceiling? Like, why can't we just use per as a float?
You suggested, sir, 59.6, we consider is 60, we'll give first class. You take float. You don't give the benefit to the student. I don't mind on that. That is not why. That is defined by the central government or CBSE board. I am only writing a program for that. That's my objective. I am not a policy maker. Why policies like this? Don't ask me a question. How do I solve this once the policy is like this? We are doing that. Is it understood our objective of writing program?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Our objective is not here to discuss the policy. Why the policy is like this? If the policy is this, how do I write a program? That's the objective. I don't argue with the policy maker. Why 59.6 will be considered 60? Why not 59? Okay, that you fight with policy maker. Okay?
Sir, why did you use
59.60? You can't use it. I mean, like this program.
Yeah.
59.60. Leke kar le, tab bhi to sahi chalega.
क्या चल रहा
प्रोग्राम
हाँ करो 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 जैसे भी द प्रोग्राम इज नॉट द ओनली वे टू राइट डाउन यू कैन राइट ऑन डिफरेंट वे व्हाटएवर वे यू फील यू कैन राइट ओके Now next. Look at this. So in P, copula, C, this, all these are there. So it can be another way also by using if else statements. We can write this. So as I told, we can put ampersand, ampersand also in between this. Greater than equal to 50, less than 60. This is declared to be second division. So I will not use else if statements. I will only use if statements over here. Then next question. This we have already done. Three inputs A, B, C. And declare their sides of a triangle. We have already done. I don't want to discuss this. I will only write down a few statements over here. If any one of this, if all these are true, if all these are true, the whole thing turns out to be true, it prints sides of a triangle. If any one of this is false, if any one of this is false, it will immediately return to zero. It prints not sides of a triangle. Is it understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Very good. Next question. Use of go-to statements. If you look at go-to statement independently, it has very less use. I can say it has no use. But go-to statement combined with if statement, it has a lot of use. Go-to statement combined with if statement has a lot of uses. Previously, as I told, we started discussing out-of-order executions. In an out-of-order execution, what I basically told, previously, whatever discussion we have made, suppose we are executing these statements. It's a if statement. There is a condition. We are supposed to execute statement like this. If I said this is S1, S2, S3, like this, we are supposed to execute a statement like this. But based upon this condition, sometimes we directly transfer control to statement number S10 if the condition turns out to be false. And that way, we do not go for a sequential execution. We go for an out-of-order execution. So, go-to is another statement. Go-to label. Label is basically the label of a statement. The label can simply be an identifier. When I write a statement, let's say in my program, I write a statement, let's say A equal to B plus. I can put a label to this statement, but the label can be written as, let's say, triple X with a colon, not semicolon, with a colon. So every statement can be preceded with, every statement can be preceded with a label, and the label will always be followed by a colon like this. A label is nothing but an identifier. I can say A9 is a label, I can say AB underscore 1 is a label, I can say ABC is also a label. It's nothing but an identifier. So, if every statement can be preceded with a label. Okay? Then, in my go-to statement, wherever I write go-to statement, suppose I wrote a go-to statement in my program somewhere, go-to, I wrote triple X. Followed by a semicolon. If I write down this, I had a statement maybe before this, before or after this somewhere, here I label triple X, colon, I my statement is A assigns to B plus C. There are so many statements after this. After execution of this, it will directly transfer control to this rather than executing this statement sequentially. So go to label means transfer control to the statements which is indicated by the label. Transfer execution to the statement which is indicated, identified by the corresponding label. That is basically. I can go to previous statement. Somewhere it is written as go to, let me say, YYY, and YYY can be a statement prior to this. Let's say A equal to B into C. Then if go to this, I'll immediately transfer control to this statement. So that's the main basically. For a out of order execution, other than the sequential execution, I can make use of a go-to statement. So go-to label. Label is basically a label to the statements, and every statement can have a label. If label is not required, I will not put a label in case of a statement unnecessarily to complicational number. But if necessary, I can put a label to a statement. A label can only be an identifier. So look at this. Label is nothing but an identifier representing a statement number. In a, sometimes we say go to page number 30. I was reading, let me say, page number 12. There is written, go to page number 30 to see the picture. I can go to page number 30 immediately to see the diagram or something like this. That's basically a transfer rather than going to page number 13, 14 sequence. That's the significance. And as I told, this will have lot of use if I combine use of go to statement along with if statement. And look at this. I have statement S1, which has a label. Label name I have not given. It can be LEBL also. Then followed by statement S2, S3, S4. Then I have go to label. So the program will be executed sequentially. This is the next statement. Whenever we come to this, go to label, will it go to next statement or it will go to S1?
S1.
S1, it will go to S2.
Yes,
then S3, again here, again it will go to level like this. So the meaning of both. And there are cases where we should avoid using go to statements. We should not write a go to statement where the label is a inner statement of a loop or inner statement of a function. Write down this. The label should not be inner statement of a loop or function definition or function definition. Syntactically it is correct, but it has a lot of side effect. We may not anticipate the correct result in that case. So avoid using the label, go to statement when label happens to be an inner statement of a loop or function definition. That I'll explain later on why it may happen.
सर आपने अभी डेफिनेशन बताया द लेवल शुड नॉट बी फुली फेड आउट
हां मैं बताया
सर एक बार वापस बताइए
और दोबारा बताऊं
हां सर
सो गो टू लेवल when we should avoid using go to level where label is the inner statement of a loop or function call. Sir, function definition. तुम लोग ये लिख लो, याद नहीं रहेगा. तुम सोचते हो याद रख लें. And why to avoid it? I'll explain it after explaining loops and functions. We should avoid. Look at this. So that is why this go to statement is avoided. I have written it inside the block of a loop or function. Now come back to this. Let's use this. We will read scores of 11 cricket players. This 2020 World Cup, let me say. And find out the average scores. And we'll find out the average score in integers. If it is 39.5, we'll say average score is 39. If you want, you can make it 40, doesn't matter. We'll find out the average scores. We'll read scores of 11 players and find out the average scores. I can take 11 variable which represent the score of each variable S1, S2, S3 like this way. I can write 11 scanner statements to read score of S1, to read, let me say, score of KL Rahul, to read the score of, let me say, Kohli or anybody else. And then I can add this. I do not want to do this. I do not want to declare so many variables. I do not want to write so many scanner sets. Look at this. How do I do this? I will only declare one variable in the name score, through which we will be taking score of individual player one after another. Score is a variable through which we will collect the score of individual players in a match one after another. And our output will be average. In integer, we will go for the four values. I take help of some temporary variable I and norm store. I will be a counter, which will count how many player score have already been taken. And now sum score is basically sum of the scores of the players whose score have already been taken. Sum score will be, initially sum score is 0. Initially my counter is 1. I have already taken up to 0th player. Counter 1 means I will take the first player scores. 1 means, counter is 1 means, I am going to take the first player scores. And then I will have a variable average score. So which will find out basically the output variable average score of the players. Now, as I told you earlier, every program we need to understand the variables which are required. How many variables do I need to declare in my program? Can anyone suggest right now?
Three, four.
Form score and average score. So four variables. All are interrelated. And I is usually counter.
Out of all four
variables, two variables I have already initialized in the declaration statement, that is the counter I and sum score equal to 0. From rest of the two variables, score and average score, are they output variable or input variable or one input, one output?
Output.
So now we will be reading the input variables one after another. Read the input. Okay? Look at this. I declare the variables. Average score I took less than 15. Doesn't matter. I could have taken integer, I took 15. Four variables, score, sum score, I essentially 0. I read the input, scan the score of the next player. Okay, I use the label, the name of the label is repeat and colon. The name of the label is repeat colon. Printf, enter the score of the next player. I wrote ith player. Then I will scan the scores. By this, what I will display here, printf can display karega? What is the value of
I? Serial number.
One. And I will take the score. And I will immediately do the computation, do the addition. My sum score will be sum score plus score. I wrote sum score plus equal to score. Is the statement understood? Everyone tell me yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So if you have not understood this, look at the right hand side statement. Look at the right hand side statement. Sum score will be previous sum score plus score of this layer. Understood it? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Will I find out the value by taking score of this player, or I need to take variable value of n players?
Ten players.
I need one after another. How do I do this? I increase my counter I. I tested. Is it less than or equal to 11? If it is less than or equal to 11, then I will repeat this. If it crosses 11, I will not repeat, I will come out of this. So now after my past attempt, I will become how much? 2? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
This is true, this will be true or false?
True.
I will go to repeat, I will go to these statements. 3 answers true, correct. If I start from here, again, and when I print this, will it print the value as 1 or it will print the value as 2?
2.
Again, it will come as you give the score of the next player. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And that score will be added to the previous scores. And now I will become?
3.
Excuse me.
Yes?
What is I here?
I is a variable declared as integer type. Listen carefully. Okay, otherwise there is no point of attending. Everything you have to listen. Now, I is less, when I became 3, is it less than 11? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
We'll go to repeat. We again go here, start executing. when I start executing this, I will be printed as 2 or will be printed as 3?
Sir,
3.
You will take the third score, add it with the previous course like this, so it will continue, this will become 4 and sometimes this will become also 11. So after reading the 11th score, this I will become 11 or it will be changed to 12?
11.
After the 11th score here, I read the 11th player score. Then I'll change I plus 1. This will become 11. 12.
12. 12.
12. 12. This statement will be true or false?
False. False. False.
False.
Will it go to repeat or it come down the next statement?
The next statement. The
next statement.
If you have understood this, tell me, this will go on reading 11 player scores and go on adding whenever the 11 player score is completely read and added, will come out of this and then I'll find out the average score equal to sum score divided by 11.0. Is it understood? Yes, yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And then I'll display the scores. The total score is equal to this. And the average score is equal to this. Sorry, I made a small mistake. Total score is not percentage F. Sum score is integer. Do write here percentage D. Small mistake is there. It's percentage D. Average score is percentage F. If the problem understood, I can read the score of 11 player one after another and find out the average. 11 player could have been possible by writing few statements over here. But if it is 100, if it is 1000, can I write this printf scanf statement 1000 times? Or I make use of this repeat and if statements?
Repeat statement.
Is this problem understood? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Next question.
Yes, sir.
Next question. Read. Again. ये बोलना पड़ रहा अभी 2020 गेम चला था इसलिए तुम लोग को याद होगा इसलिए इसी को मैं पढ़ा रहा सोचा था इंडिया फाइनल में आया नहीं आया
सबको याद है
हाँ सब कुछ याद है स्कोर वगैरह इसलिए इसी को पढ़ा रहा हाँ अब यू गॉट द प्रोग्राम अरे प्रॉब्लम का स्टेटमेंट समझ में आया कि नहीं है
हाँ सर
enter score of 10 cricket players and count the number of players score century. Maybe a test match, not a one.
Yes.
And sometimes when we enter the score, we may enter a negative score. It may happen. That's a program testing. We may enter. Should it be added in finding the average score or we should discard it?
Discarded.
So there you must take in your program by mistake user may enter some wrong value. So such type of care we should take in our program in a, as a testing as a software engineer. Now, very good. So we have to score of individual player. Number of players score century will count in a variable count. I'll take a temporary variable I by which will input value of score of 10 players. So how many variables altogether I'll take?
Three.
Square, count and I.
Sir, three
value. Count and I. What is the purpose of count is used?
Sir, to keep number of centuries.
Increment.
To count number of players who scored centuries.
Scored centuries.
Yes, very good. Same approach. We'll read the input. After reading the input, we'll check whether this is negative score someone has entered on. If a score is negative, we'll discard and repeat the same. Repeat again to read the score. If it is negative. If it is positive, we'll come here. We'll come here. And compare the score with 100. And if the score found to be greater than or equal to 100, we increase the count value by 1. We increase the count value by 1, otherwise we'll not increase. And finally, we'll repeat the previous two steps, S1 and S2. How many times will repeat it?
10 times.
10 times.
Counter IEG. So this is my whole abstract of the program.
Sir?
Yes.
Sir, we have taken the first input. Then we will repeat this step 9 times, sir. As we have to enter the value for 10 players.
I'll repeat the previous two steps for 10 times. Total 10 times repeat. Counter kya lage baat alag. How many times you repeat S1 S2? 10 times. Okay. Look at this. I declare the variables. Is the variable declaration understood to everyone? Tell me yes or no.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
आज कोई मुंह नहीं दिखा रहा है, एक बार लड़का दिखा रहा है, कोई किसी का भी आज मुंह नहीं दिख रहा है, ठीक है, कोई बात नो प्रॉब्लम, नो प्रॉब्लम, नो प्रॉब्लम. हाँ डन. अब यहाँ है अगेन, आई कुड आई रोट रिपीट हियर, आई रोट ए वर्ड अगेन फॉर बेटर अंडरस्टैंडिंग, आई गिव ए कोलन एस वन, रीड द इनपुट, रीड द इनपुट, रीडिंग इनपुट इज अंडरस्टूड एवरीवन, टेल मी यस और नो.
यस सर.
Yes, sir.
I'll check whether the score is negative or positive. Negative, I'll discard it. What's the right for the discarding? If the score is less than zero, go to A again. If it's less than zero, go to A again. Means you have not entered the score correctly. You have not entered the score correctly. Go to A again without increasing I. This is understood. Tell me yes or no.
Yes, sir.
I could have written one statement here. One printer statement. You have entered a negative score which is not accepted. I could have also displayed it for better understanding. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So we are entering the score for the same player or another player?
Same player.
I is not changed.
I plus one.
I is same, yes. Same player I am reading because I entered a wrong score. Understood it?
Yes, sir. 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 Yes, sir.
I'll increase the count. Either I'll increase, come to this step, or I'll not increase and come. Doesn't matter. When I come here, I increase my I by 1. And I wrote I less than 10. I less than 10. So if you look at this, I less than 10, go to again. If it is satisfied, I'll go to again over this. I'll start counting from 0. It will continue from 0, 1, 2, 3 up to 9. 0, 1, 2, 3 up to 9. So if I come here, go to A again, you will find out it is executed 10 times, I'll take 10 scores. Every time I'll accept the score, if the score found to be positive, fine, I'll come here to see whether it is century or not. And if it is negative, I'll keep on repeating this. And then finally, I told the number of players, my century percentage, the count. Is it understood? Tell me yes or no.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. That's true.
If yes, look at the variation. How do I write? How do I replace many statements over here? Variation. Look at this. I wrote score greater than equal to 100. I wrote score by 100. Is it understood?
Yes, sir.
Only this will give me yes, that if somebody scores more than 200. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
But
yes,
if the score is only less than 200, if it is T20 or 50-50 over match, then you won. See, is it understood when I write if score divided by 100? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Sir, once you do this, sir. Achha, if I say the score is 45, if the score is 45, मान लो स्कोर तुम्हारा 45 हो गया 65 15 स्कोर 99 व्हाट वुड बी द वैल्यू ऑफ दिस
zero
this return value will have been 0 or 1?
1.
If it is 1, it will be true. And if it is true, it will be true. It will be accountable by 1. Yes or no?
Yes, yes sir.
But only difficult is here. Somebody scored 234. Will it return 1 or 2?
2.
2, sir. 2.
Is it true or false? मतलब आगे कि ऐसा स्टेटमेंट लिखकर कैसा हो रहा है?
यस सर,
यस सर।
ये थोड़ा समझने से मुश्किल है। स्कोर करने को तो 100 वेरी डिफिकल्ट स्टेटमेंट बन रहा है। स्कोर डिवाइड बाय 100 इज रियली डिफिकल्ट। बट यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस यस और नो?
यस सर,
यस सर।
लेट मी सी अनदर वेरिएशन ऑफ दिस। दिस इज नॉट द ओनली वेरिएशन। लुक एट दिस। दिस कुड हैव अनदर वेरिएशन। लुक एट दिस। आई डिड यूज दिस स्टेटमेंट एट ऑल। I did use if statement.
Yes, sir.
Look at okay. this. Is it understood? I need to explain it.
Yes. No, sir.
No, sir. समझ गया.
अपना okay. बहुत बता देते कुछ बोलेंगे. इसका मतलब क्या रहा? Count equal to count plus score by 100. When your score is greater than equal to 100, this outcome will be giving one or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
and one
sir.
Will be
added. Yes, sir.
If the score is less than 100,
zero.
This will be?
Positive.
Zero. So zero will be added, that's all. But this will not work when your score is 234. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Two
century ho jayega. Wo kaam nahi karega. Uske liye ek chota sa cheez likhna padega. Is it understood now? Without using if statement,
yes.
I could do this will work possibly for 2020. For 2020, this will work, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Because
yes, sir.
Going more than 200, yes. I will say impossible in 2020.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Bolna chahte ho koi? Now, look
sir.
At this.
सर क्वेश्चन में ऐसे लिखा हुआ काउंट नंबर ऑफ सेंचुरी स्कोर अगर कोई प्लेयर मतलब
200
सर क्वेश्चन में 10 प्लेयर्स का बोल रहे तो आई लेस देन 10 मतलब तो सिर्फ
9 करके देखो करके देखो ये बार का लेसन करके देखो हमेशा में
0 से
स्टार्ट हुआ आई
वो बोलो स्टूडेंट हु इज आस्किंग स्टूडेंट हु इज आस्किंग डू इट ऑन योर पेन एंड पेपर एंड टेल
यस सर वो आई 0 से चल रहा है इसलिए
वो कुछ से करेगा वो बोल के समझा नहीं सकते इफ आई काउंट फ्रॉम 0 टू 10 हाउ मेनी काउंटिंग आई डिड आई मेक 0 टू इफ आई स्टार्ट काउंटिंग 0 अप टू 10 हाउ मेनी काउंटिंग डिड आई मेक 10
और 11
डबल स्लैश दे के वो स्कोर बाय 100 वाला भी करना पड़ेगा हाँ यहाँ पे इफ
वाला डबल स्लैश एक कॉमन स्टेटमेंट है आर यू अटेंडिंग क्लासेस फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम I wrote a comment. Either this if or you use this.
Achha.
यही मैंने बताया. ये replace करके कर सकता हूँ. ये भी कर सकता हूँ. ये भी कर सकता हूँ. Assuming it will not score more than 200.
अच्छा.
Understood it? I am showing many options in the same program. Is it understood? Tell me yes or no.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
All these options you should try. Now come to the conditional operator, which is a substitute for if else. Conditional operator is a ternary operator. Here we use two symbols for the ternary operator. Ternary operator means how many operands are there? Three operands are there. Ternary means three operands are there. And we use two symbols, question mark and colon. This is simply a replacement for if else statements. Now if you look at this, the syntax is like this. We write expression 1, question mark, expression 2, expression 3. This I can say operand 1, OP 2, OP 3. It's a ternary operator. And expression 1 happens to be a conditional expression. Happens to, but can be any type of expression. But this expression 1 must be returning an integer value, not a floating point value. It should not return a floating point value. It is not accepted. It can be any type of statement. पॉइंटर या इंटीजर वैल्यू नॉर्मली इज अ कंडीशनल एक्सप्रेशन टू एक्सप्रेशन थ्री कैन बी एनी टाइप ऑफ सेट कैन बी एनी टाइप ऑफ सेट से पॉज स्टेटमेंट ए प्रिंटफ स्टेटमेंट ए स्कैन स्टेटमेंट But the return value, so if the expression 1 is found to be true, if expression 1 is found to be true, non-zero is found to be true, expression 2 will return the value. Expression 3 will not be executed. Expression 2 gets executed, and the value expression 2 will return. If someone is there, he will catch it. If no one is there, it will fall. I told value being greater may fall also if no one is there to catch. And if the expression 1 gives a value 0, greater as false, expression 2 will not be evaluated, expression 3 will be evaluated, and the value will be returned. So this is as good as if conditional expression, and this part is else part. This is, I can say, a if part, and this is basically else part. But the value will return, one thing you remember. If this expression is true, expression 2 is evaluated, and the value will be returned. If someone is there, it will be caught. If no one is there, it will fall. And if this condition is found to be false, expression 2 will not be evaluated, expression 3 gets evaluated, the value will be returned. Let me write down a small expression over here. Let me write down x equal to this. I write a greater than 0, question mark, let's say 5, question mark 7. If the value of a is minus 2, this will be true or false? A assigns to 0, B, and here C. If I write this, now tell me this expression is a conditional statement or not a conditional statement?
Yes, sir.
No, it is an assignment statement. This assignment statement will return a value 0 or non-zero?
0.
Zero.
This 0 is treated as true or false?
False.
This false will return B to X or not?
Sorry.
If C is having a value 10, what is the value of X?
10.
Now, if I write down here, putting another bracket, not. And value of B is 20. 20 will be assigned or 10 will be assigned?
27.
Remember, this expression can be an assignment statement also. And when I write these statements, I may write down only A greater than 0, question mark B plus C, as B minus C. And B is 20, C is 3. If A is 10, which value will be returned? 17.
B plus C.
Is there anyone to receive it?
No, sir.
It will fall there. If somebody is there, K assigns to. K will assign myself. If K is not there, it will fall there. So when A is, let's say, 0, is it true or false?
False.
If it is false, it returns the value.
B minus C.
Yes, B minus will return. If someone is there, you will catch. Otherwise, it will fall there.
Yes, sir.
Sorry. With this idea, as I told, The expression 1 is normally, ordinarily and conditional expression, but can be any type of statement. Look at this, some examples. I wrote exercise 2, P less than 0 question mark, A plus B, A minus B. If P is negative, A plus B will be assigned to X. If P is positive, like let me say 3, 4, A minus B will be assigned to X.
Is it understood, yes or no? P less than 0.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Coming to the second one, I wrote P assigned to 0. Will it ever return 3 or always return 3 only?
Always return 3.
Assignment statement, whatever value of P we have, P could be 10, 20, 30, it will be initialized to 0, it was false, P will return here. Come to the next statement, will it return anytime 3 or always return
2?
Always return 2.
Now look at this. This will print kit or it will print inversity on the screen. Depends on the value of?
Depends on the value of I.
I is 5. It prints?
It means university.
I is 1. It prints kit. Understood? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Very good. So with this, let me ask also conditional operator, a replacement. When I have y equal to 3 or 4, depending on the value of x, I can write down x greater than 5, return 3 as return, let's say, 4 over here.
4?
As I have a greater than equal to b, then max equal to a, as max equal to b. I can write down max equal to a greater than b, return a, as return b. Is it understood?
Yeah.
How is it equal to the statement?
Yes, sir.
So, all these programs, what I told, please do it. Let me tell one or two more programs on this. Take marks of, write down, take marks of 10 students for 4 subjects, collect marks of 10 students for 4 subjects, physics, chemistry, mathematics, English. Find out how many students score above average in each subject.
Find out how many students.
How many students have scored above average marks in each subject? How many students are there in this program?
10.
For each student, how many subjects are there?
Four.
Physics, chemistry, mathematics. English, bio, I think you are not interested with. Physics, chemistry,
yes.
And yes, for every subject, for physics, you will find out marks of all 10 students, find out the average, then count how many students have scored above average. And then you do it for chemistry, do it for mathematics, do it for English, and you have to do it using if and if go to step. Cannot use for while
look. Above average, is it understood?
Is the question understood?
Yes, sir.
You can get any mark. Doesn't matter, 100 out of 100, 100 or 200, because you need to calculate out of the score above 100. Suppose I took 4 marks. Let me give an example. In physics, we have 10 students. Let me say physics. Sorry. Let's say physics. I have marks physics. This is the total score in physics. Let's say P total. Came out to be 500. Physics total, can you calculate for 10 students, yes or no? Is it audible?
Yes,
sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I calculated score of sum of score of 10 player. Can you calculate sum of physics marks for 10 students? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So physics total, chemistry total, physics total, they amount to be 500. What is the average score?
Sir.
What is the physics average?
500.
Sir.
Now you need to calculate how many students scored greater than or equal to 50. Can you calculate this or not? Some must be scored greater than or equal to 50. Agreed or not?
Yes, sir.
One student mark may be 491. Rest 9 students scored 1111. Will become 500. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
How many students scored greater than average?
One.
Like this. So you have to take marks of physics, P total, P average, then chemistry total, chemistry average. After finding average, you need to calculate how many students scored above this mark.
Yes, sir.
Once you enter the values and find out the sum, that score will be destroyed or not?
Yes, sir.
So now to do this, you have to again go for physics 1, physics 2, again 10 physics mark, like you say, you have to be 5.
Haan sir. Physics ke 10, chemistry ke 10, maths ke 10, English ke 10 sir.
ठीक है? सोचो कैसे करोगे? ठीक है? नहीं होगा तो फिर भी अच्छा है. But you have to think and do it.
Yes sir.
ठीक है? Let's try. एक subject में तो करो.
एक का
हो जाएगा सर. करो करो.
यस
इफ यू अंडरस्टूड
व्हाट आस्क
आई हैव गिवन टुडे. यस सर.
क्योंकि एवरेज निकालने का बात ही तुमको ये पूरा मार्क होना चाहिए तुम्हारे पास.
यस
सर. एवरेज निकालने से पहले नहीं कर पाएंगे. जब तुम कैलकुलेट एवरेज देन वी मस्ट रिटेन दिस वैल्यू समवेयर. If I do not retain those values, then how can I say this?
Agree?
Yes. Ek aasan kar dete ye problem ko. Don't go for average. Okay? Let me say, you will find out how many students scored above 60. Okay? In each subject. In each subject. Theek hai? Wo thoda mushkil hoga. Wo aa rahe hai, score nahi karne se mushkil hoga. And you have to do using if and go to statement. Next day, I'll discuss your loop, for loop, and while loop. Okay? But make use of go to statement and if statements. And you have to do physics, chemistry, mathematics, English. How many students have scored in each subject greater than 60? You take marks of the students from the keyboard one after another and you display it on the screen. Thank you.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, why we use percentage V in printf statement while we using the scanf statement also?
Don't use it. Are you attending for the classes for the first time?
No, sir.
Then, this is a syntax. Scanf is a library function defined by the language developer. And we have to follow that syntax.
But why we use %d in printf statement? We can also use, we can directly write enter the score of next player.
Right. Next, right?
Okay, sir.
You write that and write this. You see what benefit you are getting by this. You will get the benefit when you are, this will display, you are going to display, give the fifth player score. There you will not able to know which player I am going to give. That you do. See,
I understood.
Even if you don't write a printf, it will work. Printf is an optional statement. For better reliability. If you feel printf is not required for better reliability, don't give it. This printf statement is not mandatory, it's optional. Let me tell. Agree or not? Satyavrat, printf is mandatory or optional?
मार्क्स
ऑफ लेटर से के एल राहुल और रोहित शर्मा और कोहली यहाँ से पता चलेगा.
Yes, I think he is asking that, I mean, why we used actually percentage of D that function in the printf statement.
We can write enter the score of the next player, that's all.
That's
why
you
write
percentage of I? Yes, percentage D doesn't matter, sir. Don't write it.
Don't write it. And see what type of problem you are facing in that case. When I ask, abhi ki kiska mark dal raho, bol nahi paoge. Next, what's the next? Code value 100, you must learn also this. All this you must test. Okay?
Yes,
okay,
sir.
Thank you.
Now,
record, let me tell. Achha, do one thing. I'll enter to your class. Record, let me tell. You're supposed to submit record for all experiments. But I will suggest, write down details about one program for each day, and rest of the program you only write down the name of the experiments and the name of the file where you have saved it on your computers. Suppose today you completed all this, and for this program you submit the record for the whole program what you have written, and for rest of the program only name of the experiment and the file name in your computers. So if I want, I can check that file name in your computer someday later. Okay? So rather than writing all programs, submit, which will be a wastage of time, you submit one and rest the name of the experiment which you have solved with the file name where you have saved it in your computers. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, yes.
हम जो फाइल नेम से कंप्यूटर में सेव कर रहे हैं वो दे
सब जो खुद से करो.
Yes, sir.
Now you can enter to your breakout room.